Well, as we talk about the two Michaels returning home to Canada, Meng Huazhou is also back at her home. She left Vancouver shortly after her deal was reached yesterday, arriving at the international airport this morning in Shenzhen, China. Now, she was accompanied by China's ambassador to Canada. And as you can see by the red carpet on that jetway, she was welcomed in a grand style, a crowd of supporters lining the tarmac, welcoming Meng with cheers, music, again, that red carpet. Now, this will be her first time back in the People's Republic since being held in Canada under house arrest. Now, Natalie Collada is watching that side of the story for us today. So, Natalie, let's talk about Meng Huazhou right now. Like the two Michaels, back at home, in her case, in the People's Republic.
Very much so, Michael. And as you see, to great fanfare, just handed there on your screen, you see there a bouquet of flowers wearing red, symbolic, the color of China, as you can see, waving to individuals as well who were on the tarmac, as you mentioned, waving flags as well. She then took some time to say some prepared remarks. In that, she said she has, quote, finally returned to the warm embrace of the motherland. And then she continued on to say, as an ordinary Chinese citizen going through this difficult time, I always felt the warmth, concern of the party, the nation, and of course, the people. Now, we also saw the and have heard from the Chinese Foreign Ministry. They themselves have put out a statement saying they have been clear and consistent on their position of this whole thing, calling it a political persecution of a Chinese citizen, saying it was an incident, quote, designed to hobble Chinese high-tech companies, and then continuing on to say that this is what they call a typical case of arbitrary detention. Now, CBC has also spoken to Lynette Ong. Now, she is a associate professor at the University of Toronto. To get her take on all of this, have a listen to what she had to say.
I think from the Chinese perspective, they see that this whole episode has been portrayed as United States bullying China and elbowing Canada into doing that. And they see Ms. Meng has been, you know, has not done anything against the law and is part of this US-China competition that US is ganging up with its ally trying to contain China's growth.
So we will continue to watch and track, Michael, the geopolitical ramifications and fallout of not just this, but of course what happens with the two Michaels, what has happened and how that will influence and affect things going forward.
Now, of course, this began with Meng's arrest at Vancouver International Airport, and this ensued nearly 3 years of legal wrangling and quite concern amongst Canadians for the two Michaels.
That's right. She was arrested back in 2018. She was facing several charges, including wire fraud, fraud and conspiracy to commit wire fraud. This was on behalf of a U.S. extradition order. We can tell you that in a U.S. agreed statement of facts that was released in a U.S. court on Friday, it said that Meng told global financial institutions, and one in particular, that a company operating in Iran in violation of U.S. sanctions was, quote, a local partner of Huawei when it was in fact a subsidiary of Huawei. We also know that the BC court, throughout their extradition case, as that deal was reached with the United States. So, Michael, we will continue to watch this as it unfolds.
Okay, Natalie, thank you for that. Our Natalie Collada.